Alright guys, welcome aboard a Blue Hawaiian EC-130 helicopter. My name is Pilot Loggins, like Kenny Loggins. Anyone's first time on a helicopter today?
Me too!
I'm really excited. Just kidding. Alright, everyone got a chance to watch the safety video inside, right? Any questions on any of that stuff? Okay, perfect. Everybody's seatbelts are on, low and tight. Excellent. Alright, you two in the front seat here, you guys will be sharing this microphone. And then seat 3 and 4, you guys will be sharing a mic. Seat 5 and 6, you guys will be sharing a mic. So to use those microphones, just press and hold the black button and hold it kind of close to your mouth. Federal regulations require the microphones to be turned off while we're in the busy Honolulu airspace here, so I'm going to turn them off here in a second. As soon as we get outside of the airspace, kind of the other side of Diamond Head Crater over there, I'll turn them back on, and I'll let you guys know when they're back on. At that point, feel free to talk to each other and ask me questions. Just remember, everybody can hear what you say on the mic. Occasionally you'll see my lips moving, but you won't hear anything in your headset. Just making radio calls to air traffic control, position reports, that kind of thing. So if you have a question during that time, I won't be able to hear it. You can just wait a second and ask me again. I do talk a lot during the tour. Don't be afraid to interrupt me if you have a question. And then last but not least, we do have aloha bags in case anyone needs to say aloha to their breakfast. Hopefully we don't need these today, but just in case, some here in the front pocket, some in the pocket over on the right door, and some in the pockets behind the seats. Not too much wind today, should be a nice smooth flight. I have just a little bit of bumps here and there, and I'll try to give you guys a heads up when to expect the bumps, but nothing bad at all today. If you start to feel sick at any point during the flight though, please let me know. I might be able to slow down, smooth out the turns a little bit, make it a bit smoother. Also, what helps more than anything is just looking forward on the horizon instead of like out to the side. And you can also adjust these air vents here above your head for some fresh air. Alright guys, we're going to get our clearance to take off here and we'll be ready to go. Microphones are coming off for now. From the mountain to the ocean, from the windward to the leeward say, on the island, we do it island style. From the mountain to the ocean, from the windward to the leeward say, from the mountain to the ocean, from the windward to the leeward say. From the mountain to the ocean, from the windward to the leeward say. Alright guys, we are ready to pick up. Guys, here we go, taking off. Silver spoon in hand, Lord, don't they help themselves, y'all. Just passing the Honolulu Harbor on the left over here, really big harbor here. It handles about 11 million tons of cargo a year. Very important for the state of Hawaii because about 80% of the goods are imported to the state. So everything comes into the harbor first and then is dispersed to the seven other major islands. Which is why things are actually a little bit cheaper on Oahu than the other islands. Kind of hard to believe, I know. There are 132 islands in the entire Hawaiian island chain. Stretching about 1,600 miles from the Big Island all the way to the Kure Atoll in the northwest. Pretty nice beach up here to the front left. That's the Ala Moana Beach Park. Kind of protected from the waves from a reef under the surface here. So good calm swimming conditions off the beach. Pretty decent surf over here on this side of the reef as well. Just behind the beach over here is the Ala Moana Shopping Center. It's the largest open-air shopping mall in the United States. This is Magic Island right up here. Really nice park and protected swim area. We're gonna start a little climb right here. We'll come check out world famous Waikiki Beach up ahead. Everybody doing good so far? You guys good back there? All right. Nobody's screaming. That's a good sign. See the Atlantis submarine right there on the surface. See that white submarine? You could go on board that submarine. It goes down about 100 feet below the surface. Got Waikiki all down the left-hand side over here. We're going to do a turn here and we'll give the right side a better view. Waikiki means spouting water in the native language. There were a lot of springs and a big swamp here for a long time. And in the late 1800s, the Alawai Canal was dug to drain all this land. As the land here dried up, the first hotel was built in 1901. The Moana Surf Rider is still there to this day. If you look straight to the right, you can see the pink Royal Hawaiian Hotel right there. If you count 1, 2, 3, 4 hotels to the right from it, the short one kind of in the shape of an H right there is the Moana Surf Rider. You still see the Alawai Canal behind the skyline up here. The area right below us down here, this is considered the birthplace of modern surfing. Really good place to learn to surf. The waves aren't usually too big over here. You have Diamond Head Crater up ahead here, visible from Waikiki. Diamond Head is an extinct tuff cone volcano, first started erupting a little over 300,000 years ago. Probably get a little bit of light bumps in here in just a second, just the wind kind of coming over the crater towards us here. There used to be a fort inside the crater here called Fort Ruger. If you go on the hike to the top here, you'll see a lot of evidence of military presence. You hike through some tunnels and bunkers on your way to the top. Kind of see these like little platforms on the rim of the crater down here. Those held cannons that could fire 11 miles out to sea. It's known as Le'ahi in the native language, which translates to tuna fin because the peak kind of resembles the fin of a tuna fish from this point of view. It was named Diamond Head because the early British explorers here found little crystals in the walls of the crater and they initially mistook them for diamonds, and the name just stuck. This is the Kahala neighborhood right here to the front left. This is some of the most expensive real estate in Hawaii. Shoreline here averages around $14 million. This big white house over here on the left with the big swimming pool right there, that one is mine. I can dream, right? Pretty nice golf course here on the left. That's Wailai Golf Course and Country Club. It's on the PGA Tour. Every January, the Sony Open is held here. Pretty nice resort here next to the golf course as well. That's the Kahala Resort. Couple nice restaurants there, really pretty beach, and there's four rescue dolphins that live in a big habitat at this resort. You can visit one of the restaurants here or the beachfront bar, and you can see the dolphins. Alright guys, we're just out of Honolulu's airspace now, so the microphones are back on. So Ray, Leonard, and Jaden, where are you guys visiting from?
Philadelphia.
Oh, okay, nice. Awesome. Kind of a long flight over here, huh?
12 hours.
Yeah. It was a direct, or you have a layover somewhere?
We had a layover in Phoenix.
Gotcha. Kind of nice to break it up a little bit, huh? Well, welcome to Hawaii, guys. And then, how about you guys? Where are you guys visiting from?
Oh, my life.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Nice. Very cool. Welcome to Hawaii.
Nice to be here.
I grew up in New Orleans, Louisiana, and then I kind of lived all over different states for a little while. I moved to the state of Oregon in 2007, and I did all my flight training there, and then I was a flight instructor for a few years, then went and did tours of the Grand Canyon just outside of Las Vegas, and then had a couple different helicopter jobs after that before getting the chance to come do tours here, so moved a wife and two kids out here, and we don't want to move anymore. We like it. Pretty cool town over here to the front left. That's called Hawaii Kai. You can do a lot of fun water activities out of Hawaii Kai here. You can charter a boat, rent jet skis, go parasailing, scuba diving, bunch of fun stuff. This peak right here just behind the town, that's called Koko Crater. It's a tough cone volcano like Diamond Head back there as well. There's one really steep trail right up the slope facing us here that will take you to the top, about 1,200 feet above sea level. That was also the site of the last volcanic activity on Oahu. The last eruption of Koko Crater was about 7,000 years ago. Really pretty coastline over here where the waves come crashing in. This is called the China Walls. See this bay coming into view on the left over here? This is Hanama Bay. I'll do a turn here in a second. We'll give the right side a better view. Really pretty bay. Really good snorkeling in the bay. You can occasionally see green sea turtles in the bay. Sometimes seals swim in, usually in the afternoons. And there's over 400 species of tropical fish in the bay. The bay is closed on Mondays and Tuesdays to give the reef kind of a chance to recover from all the visitors. But you can visit Wednesday through Sunday until 3 p.m. They do require you to make a reservation to get into the bay here, but they open reservations up online 2 days in advance starting at 7 a.m. So best way to guarantee your spot in the bay, get online 2 days before you want to go, right at 7 a.m. and you'll have no problem booking your reservation. outside a better view. The bay is a caldera, like a volcanic depression, where the seaward wall has worn away over the years. It was also a favorite vacation and fishing spot of Hawaiian kings in the past. If you get the chance to visit the bay, I highly recommend it. Really pretty down there, really good snorkeling. If you don't want to do the steep hike to the top of Coco Crater here, there's a pretty nice garden inside the crater. You can drive right in, it's free to visit. Really nice and peaceful in there. See this little parking lot up here to the front left on the edge of the cliff? That's where the Honolulu blowhole is located. You can park here and watch the waves come into a lava tube cave and shoot out of an opening at the top. Sometimes shoots water like 30 to 40 feet up in the air, makes for a really cool photo. Sorry, say that again?
Yesterday we've been here.
Oh, okay, gotcha, nice. Yeah, pretty cool little like beach down here next to the blowhole as well, that's really fun. There was some water out of the blowhole. You can't really see it today through the haze, but the island of Molokai is over in that direction, kind of front right over there, about 25 miles away. That's the closest major island to us. After Molokai, you'll come to Lanai, then Maui, and the big island of Hawaii, all in that direction. A few months ago, one of our pilots flew a guy over to Molokai and dropped him off there. He'd been training for a long time. He actually swam all the way back to Oahu. Crazy, huh? He had a boat following him for safety in case he needed help, but he made it the whole way, 25-mile swim. Over here to the left, this is called Makapu'u Point. That's Makapu'u Lighthouse on the edge of the cliff right there. There's a parking lot down here and a nice paved walking path about a mile to the top up here. Really pretty views. Before the lighthouse was here, the native Hawaiians used to light big signal fires on the edge of the cliffs down here to help the boats at sea here navigate. Makapu'u translates to bulging eye in the native language. Down here to the left, this is Sea Life Park. You can see marine life shows here. You can swim with dolphins here. Good luau's here as well. This island right over here to your right, that's called Rabbit Island. Kind of vaguely looks like a rabbit's face on the right with its ears behind it to the left. But it's one of the few islands here you're actually not allowed to visit. It's a seabird sanctuary today, so the whole island is reserved for seabird nesting grounds. And you have this long beach over here on the left. This is called Waimanalo Beach. This is actually the longest stretch of uninterrupted sandy beach on Oahu. It's about 5 miles long from end to end. Former President Barack Obama just built a house right down here at this end of Waimanalo. My wife and daughter went to this beach here, and there was Secret Service standing on the beach in front of his house. Great beach to come to if you get tired of all the crowds over at Waikiki. Drive over here, you can find a big stretch of sandy beach all to yourself here, especially on the weekdays. Very few people here on the weekdays. These two little islands straight ahead up here, those are the Mokulua Islands, also known as the Mokes. You can visit those islands, you can kayak out to them. They're actually the most photographed islands in the entire state of Hawaii. Big reason for that is there's a hike on this ridge up ahead. It's called the Lani Kai Pillbox Hike. You can hike to a couple of World War II bunkers that are still up there. Photographers will often hike up here in the early morning and photograph the sun rising between the two islands. I was on that beach with my daughter a couple weeks ago. It was a big seal just sitting on the beach right there. Over here to the left, this is Bellows Air Force Base down here. All the runways here are long closed, but they still do training here. And this was one of the airports that was attacked during the attack on Pearl Harbor. You can see this peak straight ahead up here. That's called Olamana. The name means divided hill in the native language. This is left over from the Ko'olau volcano, one of the two really large volcanoes that created Oahu here. You kind of see the Ko'olau mountain range back here. Kind of wraps around in like a semicircle. These mountains here were about one half of the rim of that volcano, so it gives you an idea of how big that volcano was. You can hike these three peaks of Olamana here. The one on the right there, it's the first one you'll get to and the easiest one to get to. Most people hike up to that first peak and then back down. I see some clouds forming right off the peaks here. Terrain pushes that moist air up, condenses into clouds. Probably get a little bit of light bumps over here on this side of Olamana, just the way the wind comes over the peaks towards us here. This town over here to the right, this is called Kailua. Really nice town here on the windward side of the island. I live in Kailua by this little lake over here on the right. That's actually the truth this time. A lot of nice restaurants and shopping over here in downtown Kailua. Really pretty beach here as well, Kailua Beach. Really like soft, powdery sand. Really popular spot for kite surfing because this is the windy side of the island. Up ahead here, this really big bay in front of us, this is called Kaneohe Bay. Really pretty bay here, a lot of coral formations in the bay, tons of marine life here as well. There's a lot of green sea turtles, sometimes seals and dolphins swim in. The occasional giant manta ray spotted here, as well as the occasional tiger shark and hammerhead shark. Up ahead on this big peninsula up here, that's Kaneohe Marine Corps Base. I was just talking to them back there to get permission to fly through here. This was also one of the airports attacked during the attack on Pearl Harbor. You have this little island over here to the front left. That's called Coconut Island. You guys remember the TV show Gilligan's Island? Some of Gilligan's Island was filmed right here. This whole time, Gilligan could have just swam ashore right here. Today, this is a marine life research institute ran by the University of Hawaii. But you can still visit and tour the island.
Mahalo, aloha, everybody. Thank you.
You can see all the coral formations down here in the bay. So as this coral has grown and eroded over time, it created a lot of sand, which eventually created this really big sandbar straight ahead in the middle of the bay. That's Kaneohe Sandbar. A really fun thing to do if you come over here to this side of the island, you can get on a tour boat that will take you out to the sandbar here. You can also just rent a boat or kayak from some of the marinas in the bay and come out to the sandbar on your own.
Where is the valley of the Tapas?
You mean like the Jurassic Valley?
Valley of the Tapas.
So that's over on the North Shore a little bit later. Near Pupukea. I'll point it out to you when we're there. Really fun out here on the sandbar. Really good snorkeling, good fishing, pretty views looking back at the mountains. The water's pretty shallow as well. It's about waist deep most places. This is some of the healthiest coral anywhere around Oahu. All these circular formations down here. See that little island straight ahead up here, that's called Mokolii. And you can visit that island, you can kayak or paddleboard out to it. Some people even swim out to the island from Kualoa Beach, a little beach up ahead. There's a little hike that will take you to the top. Really pretty views. You can see these two ponds straight ahead up here. Those are called the Moli'i Fish Ponds. They're a historic site. Believed to have been built between 600 and 900 years ago. Well, the Hawaiian people actually built this seawall out into the bay here. One little entrance to the ponds at the end so small fish could swim in. And then the fish would eventually grow too large to swim back out. It was like a big fish trap. There's a local legend here that a goddess fought a giant lizard in the mountains over here. And she pulled his tail off and threw it into the ocean. So that's the tip of the lizard's tail sticking up. Mokolii translates to Lizard Island. Right here to the front left, that's the Kualoa Ranch down here. A big cattle ranch here. And you can do a lot of fun activities out of the ranch. You can go horseback riding, zip lining, go on ATV tours, e-bike tours as well. On your tour out of the ranch here, you'll enter this really pretty valley that's about to come into view on the left here in a second. But we'll fly through a little bit of light rain here as well. But this valley is called the Ka'aava Valley. It's famous for a lot of movies and TV shows filmed here. Jurassic Park, Jurassic World, Godzilla, Kong Skull Island, Jumanji, 51st Dates. We go on and on. Almost 200 movies and TV shows have at least some scenes filmed here. Do a quick turn here, we'll get the right side of view of the valley here. It's still an active cattle ranch. You'll often see cattle in the valley here. Just did the e-bike tour through the valley here last week. Really fun.
Are we going to see any waterfalls or no?
We'll see. There's one up here. A lot of the time is covered in clouds. We'll come up here and see if we can get a peek of it. This is the wet side of the island over here. This side of the island gets the most rainfall by far. The winds here are out of the northeast the majority of the time, the trade winds. They come in from the right over here, bringing a lot of moisture with them from the Pacific Ocean. All that moisture hits this rising terrain here and condenses into clouds, often clouds here at the top of these mountains. These mountains get a ton of rain a year, about 300 inches of rain a year at the top of the mountains. Shoreline here gets about 200 inches a year. And when compared to Honolulu, which gets about 30 inches of rain a year, really big difference over here. But it keeps everything really nice and green year-round this side of the island. This is all tropical rainforest over here. Come in here and see if we can get a glimpse of this waterfall. Definitely have some low clouds here, but I think we'll be able to see at least the main section of the waterfall. It's going to be in this canyon up here. We're coming to view on the left side first, and then I'll do a turn and put it out the right side. Okay, we can see it. It's gonna just come into view over here on the left. Here, right there, that's the main section. There used to be a hike that you could do here. 1999, though, there was a big landslide on the trail, and so they closed the trail. It's never been reopened. That waterfall never stops flowing, it's just constantly being fed by all the rain and the mountains here. That's about as close as we can safely get.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course. If I can safely show it to you, I will. Alright, left side will get another quick view here as we depart. Thank you. looks like this rain is going to clear up ahead here. Is that dripping over there? I got a towel here if you want. Good, okay. That's not supposed to leak. I'll tell the mechanics after this. I can patch that up. You can see some of these light green trees kind of sprinkled in here and there. Those are all kukui trees. It's a sacred tree to the Hawaiian people. You've probably seen the polished kukui nuts on necklaces. The oil from that nut is used for ceremonial purposes and also in traditional canoe building. It's waterproof. Also see all those tall pine trees down there on the right. There's a grove of them here to the front left as well. They kind of look out of place here because they're not indigenous to the island. They kind of have an interesting story. When Captain James Cook, the British explorer, first came to the Hawaiian Islands in 1778, he found there were no suitable trees here for mast repairs to his ships. So he planted a few of these tall pine trees here, and now you can see them all over the islands. A town straight to your right over here, that's Laie, L-A-I-E. Pretty nice laid-back town here on the northeast side. Some really pretty beaches and bays around Laie. The Polynesian Cultural Center is located there as well. Really cool place to visit. They have really big authentic shows and luau's held there. In the past, Laie was a place of refuge for the Hawaiian people. If there was a battle or a disagreement, someone was afraid for their life, they could seek refuge there, and they were not allowed to be harmed. So I go there when my wife is really mad at me. You can't harm me. You see all these ponds up here to the front right? Those are all shrimp farms. If you come to the North Shore up ahead here, you'll see a lot of food trucks just off the road. You can stop and get some garlic shrimp. Really tasty and super fresh because it all comes from right here. There's one called Giovanni's right outside of Laie back there that's really popular. Another one is Kahuku Shrimp Company. Straight ahead up here, these white domes, that's the Opana radar site. Kind of has an interesting history. So during the attack on Pearl Harbor, December 7th, 1941, the radar site right here was brand new, but it was working. They actually did detect the Japanese aircraft coming from offshore up ahead. But they were expecting a large fleet of U.S. bomber airplanes to arrive from California that day. So they thought it was the U.S. bombers coming in and decided not to raise the alarm. Right up here to the front right, that's Turtle Bay Resort. Really nice resort here on the North Shore. It's actually the only resort on the North Shore. A couple of nice restaurants there. A couple of golf courses. Really pretty beach and bay. A lot of water activities you can do right out of the resort. You can take part in all that without being a guest of the resort as well. And then this is the North Shore all along here. About 17 miles of shoreline here. Some really pretty beaches over here on the North Shore. Some famous surfing destinations as well. This beach that kind of juts out right here. This is called Sunset Beach. Surfing competitions are held right here in the winter months. The waves are the biggest over here in the winter. You can have like 20, 30, 40 foot waves some days here in the winter.
I am my owner.
If you're ever here, like early December through about mid-April, you can often spot humpback whales along the North Shore here. The humpback whales travel here all the way from Alaska, 3,000 miles away. They come here to mate and give birth to their young in these warmer waters. As soon as the babies are big enough to make the journey, they head all the way back up to Alaska. They make a 3,000 mile journey two times a year. Pretty crazy. There's Long Beach here on the left. This is called the Bonsai Pipeline. Big surfing competitions are held here as well. See this rocky cove up here to the front left. That's called Shark's Cove. It's named that because it's kind of in the shape of a hammerhead shark. As long as it's not too rough in the cove, really good snorkeling in there. A lot of fish, green sea turtles occasionally as well. I'll do a turn here in a second. We'll get the right side, a better view. This bay right here, this is called Waimea Bay. Really nice beach and bay here, kind of protected from the waves a bit. You see that big rock at the end of the beach right there? People jump off that rock all day, really fun. There's a really good food truck lot on the other side of the road from Shark's Cove down here. And there's a snorkel equipment rental at the food truck lot. So this is Pupukea up here, and this is the temple at the back here. I think maybe that's what you're referring to. If you turn off the road down here at Waimea Bay, go just up this river right here. There's a really pretty botanical gardens in this little canyon on the left. There's a waterfall there, Waimea Falls. You can swim at the base of the waterfall as part of your entry to the gardens. You can see all these solar panels and wind turbines here in front of us, as well as other parts of the island. So Oahu here has a goal to be 100% green energy by the year 2045. Right now they're a little over 30% green energy. I'm still waiting to see that 30% reflected in my electric bill though. I haven't seen that yet. There's a beach over here on the right. See that big sandy parking lot over there on our side of the road? You could park in that sandy parking lot right there and walk across the road. You're almost guaranteed to see green sea turtles on the beach right there. It's called Laniakea Beach, but also known as Turtle Beach. It's like a resting spot for sea turtles. I think I've been there maybe 5 or 6 times and seen turtles every single time. So this is called the Central Valley, so the valley between the two mountain ranges on Oahu, the Ko'olau Mountains on the left, the Waianae Mountains on the right. So these mountains either side of us here are what's left of the two really large volcanoes that created Oahu here. The Waianae volcano on the right there started erupting first about 4 million years ago. And about 1 million years later, the Ko'olau volcano on the left started erupting. Over time, they met in the middle here, creating this valley between the two. There's a lot of agriculture here in the Central Valley, a lot of tropical fruit is grown here, pineapple, mango, papaya, bananas, also macadamia nuts, coffee, and chocolate. Straight ahead up here, this really big farm in front of us, all these long rectangular fields, that's the Dole Pineapple Farm, established in 1901. So those are all pineapples at various stages of growth. It takes the pineapples here almost 2 years to come to full maturity before they can be harvested, about 22 months on average. Each pineapple plant at this entire farm is hand planted as well, a lot of work. Alright guys, how about I land right down here? You guys hop out, grab as many pineapples as you can, and get back in, alright? They can spare a few, look how many they have.
I'll save you.
If you drive from Honolulu to the North Shore, you'll pass right by the Dole Pineapple Visitors Center, these orange rooftops up here just off the road. Great place to stop on your way, you can get out, take a rest, have some pineapple ice cream, really good. Have some gardens here you can stroll through. They do a couple of tours of the grounds on trains as well. There's a big pineapple shaped garden maze just coming into view over here on the right. Nothing else though, definitely get some pineapple ice cream. I think it's the best on the island right here. Someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like a lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where. The path here from the North Shore through the valley to Pearl Harbor up ahead, this is the same direction the attack came from during the attack on Pearl Harbor. Their first target was this airport you can see right up ahead here. It was called Wheeler Army Air Corps Base at the time. There were U.S. fighter and bomber airplanes all lined up down here wingtip to wingtip. So the Japanese strategy was to take out as many of those aircraft as they could before they were able to take off. And it was very effective. Of the 140 aircraft that were here, only 12 were able to take off after the attack. Today it's a Army helicopter base. You can see all the Army helicopters down here, Chinook, Black Hawk, and Apache helicopters. There's apparently still some evidence visible from the attack at ground level here, some bomb craters that have never been fully filled, bullet holes and old hangars that are still there, and some shrapnel and some of the old tarmac as well. Town over to your right there, that's called Schofield Barracks. It's a big military town for all the military personnel stationed here. Tallest point on the island is right up in the clouds over there to the right. Can't see the top of it right now. That peak's called Ka'ala. It's about 4,025 feet above sea level. These are banana farms down here, these kind of bushy green crops. These are the apple banana variety, little small bananas. really flavorful. Couple of radio calls to Honolulu approach real quick. We'll get permission to enter their airspace again. We'll fly over Pearl Harbor up ahead. I'll be a little bit quiet for about a minute or so here while I get hard clearance. Alright guys, we just got cleared into Honolulu's airspace here. So you can see the one entrance to the harbor at the shoreline over there. Then you have the west lock of the harbor on the right, the middle lock here in front of us, the east lock on the left. That's Ford Island up ahead, the middle of the east lock. The middle lock right down here in front of us, this is a Navy repair station today, so these ships here are in like various stages or need of repair. Some of them are used for training exercises as well. And Ford Island up here, this was the primary target during the attack on Pearl Harbor. The attack here started a little before 8 a.m. December 7th, 1941, and it lasted a little over an hour. There were U.S. Navy ships anchored on all sides of Ford Island here. In total, 360 Japanese aircraft attacked here, fighters, low-level bombers, and torpedo bombers. You can still see a couple of shipwrecks here that were never raised after the attack. First one you can see is right straight ahead, our side of the island. See that little white dock sticking out from the island? Just off of the white dock right there is the USS Utah laying over on her side. I'll do a turn here in a second. We'll give the left side a better view. 58 sailors lost their life when the Utah sank. 54 remain on board to this day. And that white dock there is a memorial to those that lost their life. Over on the other side of the island, that big battleship right there, that's the USS Missouri. It's a museum today. You can go on board. Also where the treaty was signed to end World War II. And right in front of the Missouri, under this big white memorial here, that's the USS Arizona. That's where the largest loss of life here occurred. 1,177 sailors lost their life when the Arizona sank, which was almost half of the total loss of life in the attack. an armor-piercing bomb struck the magazine room where the ammunition was stored on the Arizona, resulting in a really large explosion. The Arizona sank very rapidly, which is why there was such a large loss of life there. Both the Arizona and the Utah up here are still leaking some oil to this day, over 82 years later. Estimated to be on average about 6 quarts of oil a day between the two ships. Arizona sank with about 500,000 gallons of fuel and oil on board. Kind of a little bit of symbolism in the positioning of the Arizona and Missouri over here. You have the Arizona in front, where World War II kind of began for the United States, and then the Missouri behind it, where the treaty was signed to end the war, so kind of beginning and ending of the war symbolized. Now you can actually see a little bit of oil on the surface there. Here the Arizona. They're kind of shining on the surface. And right down here at the end of the bridge, that's the Pearl Harbor Visitor Center. You can learn about all the history there. You can take a boat out to the Arizona Memorial. And you can see that decommissioned World War II submarine right here on the right. That's the USS Bowfin. You can go on board the Bowfin. Alright guys, we're just entering Honolulu's busy core airspace here, so I'm going to turn the microphones off for now. We'll get our clearance to land and bring it back to the airport up ahead here. This is where the modern U.S. Navy ships are, this part of the harbor here on the right. I see a couple of nuclear submarines docked right over there to the right. This is an Air Force base over here to the right called Hickam Air Force Base. They use the same runways as the airlines here at Honolulu Airport. Alright guys, we just got cleared to land at Honolulu Airport here. Thank you guys so much for flying with me today. I hope you have enjoyed the tour. Once we land, just stay in your seat with your seatbelt fastened, please, until I get the engine shut down and the blade stop spinning. At that point, the ground crew will come open your doors and help you out of the helicopter. Please feel free to leave us a review. We appreciate all feedback. It's how we get better at doing tours. We have some comment cards in the office. We always enjoy reading your guys' comments. If you guys enjoyed the tour today, my name is Pilot Loggins, like Kenny Loggins. If you did not enjoy the tour, my name is Steve. Okay. Just kidding. All right, sit back and relax, guys. We'll be on the ground here shortly.